Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Simplifying UPSC with Ease with me Arpita Sharma. Today we are going to start with important events or conferences. Aaj hum art and culture mein important events jo hue hain ya conferences hui hain unhe samjhenge aur padhenge. Now the first very important event is Kumbh Mela 2019. Now the Kumbh Mela, as we all know, it is the world's largest religious and also cultural human congregation. यहाँ पर दुनिया के हर कोने से जो भक्त हैं वो इकट्ठा होते हैं, right? And ये जो कुंभ मेला 2019 का हुआ था, ये प्रयागराज में शुरू हुआ था, पहले जिसे अलाहाबाद कहा जाता था उत्तर प्रदेश में, January 15, 2019 को, right? So this Kumbh 2019, it began at Prayagraj. This is important for prelims, which is erstwhile or Allahabad at UP on January 15, 2019. Now there is a mythical story which is associated with Kumbh Mela. Now as you can all see, this is known as the Samudra Manthan. Write it down, the Samudra Manthan. Now this Samudra Manthan happened, in which there was a huge large snake which was a devotee of Lord Shiva. It was tied round the mountain in the mid of an ocean, okay, and these were the devils and these were the gods, and they, you know, undertook the Samudra Manthan, in which there was a kalash, there was a pot of amrit which appeared, right? So there was a pot of amrit which appeared, and in the fear that the devils, if they consume this amrit, they will live, you know, they will, nobody can kill them, right? Nobody can kill them, nobody can finish them, and they will become powerful. So because of which, Lord Vishnu, he took this kalash, he took this pot of amrit, and he ran away. While he was running away with this pot of amrit, there were drops of this amrit which fell down in Ujjain, Haridwar, Nashik and Prayagraj. In Haridwar it fell down in the Ganges in Uttarakhand. In Ujjain it fell down in the Shipra river in Madhya Pradesh. These are the rivers, okay? In Nashik it fell down in Godavari river in Maharashtra, and in Prayagraj, that is Allahabad, it fell down on the confluence of Ganga, Yamuna and Saraswati, which is also known as the Sangam river in Uttar Pradesh. Okay, that is why these rivers are considered as very sacred, and people from around the world, they take holy dips into these rivers. So हुआ क्या था, समुद्र मंथन के दौरान जब अमृत का कलश प्राप्त किया था देवताओं ने और राक्षसों ने, तो देवताओं को ये डर था कि अमृत ग्रहण करने के बाद राक्षस बहुत पावरफुल हो जाएंगे, उन्हें खत्म करना मुश्किल हो जाएगा. तो लॉर्ड विष्णु ने इसी वजह से जो अमृत का कलश था उसे उठाकर वो भागना शुरू हुए, जिसके कारण कुछ ड्रॉप्स जो हैं अमृत के वो चार नदियों में गिर गए. एक तो थी हरिद्वार में गंगा रिवर, उज्जैन में शिप्रा रिवर, नासिक में गोदावरी रिवर, और प्रयागराज में गंगा, यमुना और सरस्वती के मेल जो संगम रिवर थी, वहां जाकर वो ड्रॉप्स गिरे. तो इसलिए ये जो रिवर्स हैं इनको बहुत ही ज्यादा सेक्रेट माना जाता है, और हर साल जो भी कुंभ मेला ऑर्गेनाइज किया जाता है वहां पर दुनिया के हर कोने से लोग आकर इन नदियों में डुबकी लगाते हैं. सो दिस कुंभ मेला इज ऑल्सो नोन एज फेस्टिवल ऑफ सेक्रेट पिक्चर. दिस वॉज दी सेक्रेट पिक्चर, ओके, ये था वो सेक्रेट पॉट, ये सेक्रेट पिक्चर. Now this festival is also included in the list of intangible cultural heritage of humanity by UNESCO in which year? In 2017. Why intangible? Because you cannot touch this festival. Tangible means the thing which you can touch. Intangible means the thing which you cannot touch. Now crowds gather at the sacred confluence of Ganga, Yamuna and mystical river Saraswati. It is celebrated 4 times over a period of, over a course of 12 years. 12 saal mein 4 baar ye celebrate kiya jata hai festival. Why 4 times? Once in Haridwar, once in Ujjain, once in Nashik and once in Prayagraj. 4 jagah celebrate hota hai, to 12 saal mein 4 baar celebrate hota hai. Okay? Now the next important event is Sanjhi Mujhme Kalakar. Now, what is this सांझी मुझमें कलाकार? सांझी means to share and to partner. सांझी का मतलब है किसी के साथ partnership करना या किसी के साथ share करना, कुछ बांटना. So the संगीत नाटक academy, which is also the National Academy of Music, Dance and Drama, underline this. संगीत नाटक academy जो है वो dance, music और drama की national academy है. It will launch the second phase of the web campaign. ये एक तरीके का web campaign है, online campaign है, सांझी मुझमें कलाकार. It is an initiative to document, because it's a web campaign, तो documentary बनेगी, right? It is an initiative to document and also to promote the intangible cultural heritage of India. Intangible cultural heritage related to music, dance, drama and diverse cultural traditions of the country by direct public participation. लोगों को directly इसमें participate करवा कर इस तरीके जो हमारे intangible cultural heritage है, dance है, music है, drama, उसे promote करवाया जाएगा online, web campaign है, okay? Now the main focus of this second phase of Sanji Mujhme Kalakar will be on promoting harvest seasons, folk culture, traditional culture or event, custom, social events, ritualistic art forms, etc. Now the next question comes, what do we mean by intangible cultural heritage? Ye intangible cultural heritage hota kya hai? What is this ICH? Intangible cultural heritage. So the intangible cultural heritage, this particular term includes the monuments, it includes collection of objects, knowledge, crafts, events, rituals, arts, performing arts, dance, music, drama, oral traditions, stories, which we have taken from our ancestors. Now comes the very famous Bhima Koregaon anniversary, on which there was a large amount of controversy last year. Now, the Bhima Koregaon anniversary, Jan 1st, 2018, marked the 201st anniversary. And 202nd anniversary was on Jan 1st, 2019. Okay, now this is a battle. This Bhima Koregaon was a battle. This was a battle. Battle between the Dalits and the Peshwas, that who were the Brahmins. Now, basically the British army fought against the Peshwas, but in the British army, it comprised of mainly Dalit soldiers. And this battle took place when? On Jan 1st, 1818. You have to remember the year. Year is very important. It can be asked. For prelims, it is very important. 1818 mein hua tha Bhima Koregaon ka battle, jisme British army ne Peshwa forces ke khilaf yuddh, lada tha. British army mein Dalits the, Mahar Dalits the. Right, they fought this battle against the Peshwas, who were the Brahmins. And this battle, in this battle, the British troops defeated the Peshwa army. Isme jeet kiski hui thi? British army ki, Dalits ki jeet hui thi. And the victory was seen as a win against the caste-based discrimination and oppression. Now, there are three very important events. First is the World Hindi Day. Second is the National Hindi Divas. Divas means day. 11th World Hindi Conference. Now, World Hindi Day is celebrated on Jan 10 every year. Har saal 10 January ko hi celebrate kiya jata hai. And it marks the anniversary of the first World Hindi Conference, which was held in 1975 in Nagpur. 1975 mein Nagpur mein sabse pehla World Hindi Conference conduct kiya gaya tha. Usi ko celebrate karne ke liye, usi ki anniversary celebrate karne ke liye World Hindi Day manaya jata hai, right? To celebrate the anniversary of the same, World Hindi Day is celebrated. Then comes the 11th World Hindi Conference. It was this time in 2019, it was held in Mauritius. Mauritius mein isko kiya gaya, conduct karwaya gaya. And the theme of this conference this year was Vaishvik Hindi aur Bharatiya Sanskriti. It is held once in 3 years. Teen saal mein ek baar ye conduct kiya jata hai. And it is dedicated to Hindi language, Hindi bhasha ko dedicated rehta hai ye. Pehla World Hindi Conference kab hua tha? Nagpur mein hua tha 1975 mein. The first World Hindi Conference was conducted in Nagpur in 1975. But National Hindi Divas is separate. It is different from World Hindi Day. National Hindi Divas World Hindi Day se bilkul hi alag hai. Why? Because it is celebrated every year on which date? September 14. And this date, on this same date, September 14 ko hi, in 1949, our Constituent Assembly adopted Hindi, which is written in Devanagari script, as the official language of the Union, under which article? Article 343. September 14 ke din hi, 1949 में हमारी कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट असेंबली ने आर्टिकल 343 के तहत हिंदी को हमारे यूनियन का, देवनागरी स्क्रिप्ट में लिखी हुई हिंदी लैंग्वेज को हमारी यूनियन का ऑफिशियल लैंग्वेज घोषित किया था. सो नेशनल हिंदी दिवस इज सेलिब्रेटेड टू मार्क द अडेप्टेशन ऑफ हिंदी ओनली, टू मार्क द अडेप्टेशन ऑफ हिंदी लैंग्वेज एज द ऑफिशियल लैंग्वेज इन 1949. ओके, सो इट इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम नेशनल हिंदी वर्ल्ड हिंदी डे, बिकॉज वर्ल्ड हिंदी डे तो वर्ल्ड हिंदी कॉन्फ्रेंस के को सेलिब्रेट करने के लिए मनाया जाता है. नेशनल हिंदी दिवस तो हिंदी को ऑफिशियल लैंग्वेज के तौर पर अडेप्ट करने के लिए मनाया जाता है. ओके, नाउ कम्स 2018's वर्ल्ड संस्कृत कॉन्फ्रेंस. नाउ दिस टाइप ऑफ कॉन्फ्रेंस इज कंडक्टेड एवरी 3 years, हर 3 साल में ये कॉन्फ्रेंस कंडक्ट करवाया जाता है अंडर द इंटरनेशनल एसोसिएशन ऑफ संस्कृत स्टडीज. ओके, नाउ दिस पर्टिकुलर कॉन्फ्रेंस वॉज होस्टेड बाय डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एशियन स्टडीज एट यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ ब्रिटिश कोलंबिया इन कैनेडा, अंडरलाइन कैनेडा में कंडक्ट किया गया था. इट इज 17th सच कॉन्फ्रेंस सेलिब्रेटेड इन 2018 एंड इट्स द प्रीमियर टॉप मोस्ट इंटरनेशनल फोरम फॉर प्रोफेशनल रिसर्चर्स एंड एजुकेटर्स ऑफ संस्कृत लैंग्वेज. ओके, अब जितने भी प्रोफेसर्स है, स्कॉलर्स है, एजुकेटर्स है संस्कृत लैंग्वेज के, इस हिस्ट्री, रिलीजन, इस लैंग्वेज के, इस लैंग्वेज के कल्चर को डिस्कस किया जाता है इस पर्टिकुलर कॉन्फ्रेंस में.